A few weeks ago, a couple of weeks ago, I trundled off down to the Manic Street Preachers studio for a world-exclusive interview. I got to speak to James Dean Bradfield, and he talked me through some of the tracks of the album, but I began by posing him a question relating to the sort of pressures the band had been under with this one. Now, the Manics, more than any group I can think of virtually in history, have come under what I would call external pressure at the release of every single album. There's always been something there, and you seem to be in the spotlight for one reason or another. Every band's in the spotlight for the second album. But then, with the last album, it was the first album without Richie. With this one, it's the first that's had no lyrical input. Do you get a bit tired of this incessant kind of banging on about there must be some pressure there?
I think we were one of the only bands that kind of, that people actually kind of think that there's always something there that we can portray. You know, kind of everything we've done in the past is so loaded with something that there's always, people kind of can easily, always seem to think that it's easy to level the accusation of selling out to something. So kind of, you know, it's quite hard. It feels like a lot of pressure sometimes. Present to be afraid of cold. So if I can't shoot rabbits, then I can't shoot fascists. That amount of scrutiny actually keeps you on your toes, and sometimes it's entertaining, and sometimes it's just scary. Bullets fly our brain today, but we'll forget it all again. Monuments put from pen to paper turns me into a godless woman.
I think Nicky said that it was an album of purity and beauty. Was this something that you set about to achieve from the outset?
Basically, we always work off some kind of reflex. I always like to think it's something very natural. But if I look at the preceding albums, you know, Holy Bible and Everything Must Go, you know, Holy Bible was just a very nihilistic album. And Everything Must Go was just the sound of a band trying to free itself from something, or like just trying to escape from something, perhaps itself, perhaps its own past. And like, this is the first album where I just felt that every lyric that Nick gave me was completely realised. It was almost, for me, his scripture. He wasn't trying to prove a point to himself or anybody else. It was just his truth, basically, and I just wanted to reflect. So kind of, I want to kind of try and reflect that serenity, that kind of purity of belief and thought.
The gap that grows between our lives, the gap our parents never had. Stop those thoughts, control your mind. Replace the things that...
How did the title come to you?
We stole that off an Iron Bevan. Obviously, Iron Revan, you know, the Welsh politician, set up the National Health Service and stuff. And at the end of his meetings, you know, kind of back in the old days, back in the fire and brimstone days, you know, kind of at the end of his, you know, in any given town hall, etc., he'd say at the end of the night, you know, this is my truth, tell me yours. And we just felt it was very apt.
In the beginning, when we were winning,
I'd just like to go through a few of the tracks, if that's all right. So if we begin with Ready for Drowning.
The first aspect of the song was to say, you know, the most intelligent or most beautiful or most successful Welsh people always end up kind of like leaving Wales as they become successful or as they become recognised. And you kind of, they usually return in a box. You know, they usually end up, you know, they usually end up leaving Wales, drinking themselves to death, and they usually end up returning in the coffin, you know. And it's just saying, Nick was just saying, you know, that kind of reflects, I think that reflects kind of like a certain self-loathing in Welsh culture.
He has a true story, said someone to me yesterday, said he got it in a taxi.
And then the kind of the song worked on the other level of, there's a town in North Wales, it was this town in the middle of a valley, and they wanted to flood it to make a reservoir so you could supply Liverpool with a new source of water. And basically, so they had to evacuate that town, they just flooded the valley just so they could, you know, supply Liverpool with water. And sometimes the water level goes down to such a degree that you can actually see the old existing town at the bottom of the valley.
So where are we going?
least all the stuff from my art is kind of a tiny bit about touring. It's just about being compelled to do things that are the most important things to you, but actually it's just those things that you do actually kind of very alien to your personality. But you still feel compelled to do them because it's the only way you can get your point across. So basically the song is just more of a love song towards loss of innocence than anything, to be honest.
Dead on my shoulder then, and the string arrangements come through loud and clear there, don't yeah. they? But the strings are back again. One of the most intriguing titles on the album.
Again, that's stolen from Winston Churchill to a certain degree. He used to suffer from manic depression, and in his diaries, you know, when the day he'd be suffering from, you know, such depression, the only entry will be Black Dog.
Winston Churchill, can you hear my voice? Melodrama, there in my kitchen sink.
It's just dealing with depression in a very un-rock and roll way. You know, millions of people, you know, working in a factory or just, you know, just working in a shop, etc. Millions of people suffer from, you know, deep depression, but they just get on with things. They don't kind of, like, you know, get themselves prescribed with Prozac. And basically dealing with depression in a very kind of, like, dare I say it, housewife kind of fashion, which I think is the way Nick deals with it. Musically, it's one of the only songs that is a bit of a pastiche, I think. Other people say others are, but that song directly, I wanted to be like a Midnight Cowboy kind of vibe, really. Or like Wichita Lineman, Glen Campbell kind of thing.
It is just a stunning album, set to go into the album charts at number one. It's called This Is My Truth, Tell Me Yours by the Manic Street Preachers. And there, you have my exclusive chat with James Dean Bradley.